Hey guys, Pitmaster, I'm here with Vato, and we're gonna answer the age-old question, to spin or not to spin? Should you spin or should you not spin? If you watch karate tournaments, there's a lot of spinning techniques. Spinning hook kicks, spinning back kicks, spinning back fists, all kinds of spinning techniques. And then you go a little higher, like kickboxing, you don't see quite as much, but they're still spinning back kicks. Then they've added spinning elbows and even spinning back fists, okay? So there's a little more, but not quite as much in karate. Now MMA, we've seen a spinning hook kick knockout. We've seen tons of spinning elbow knockouts. We've seen spinning back fist knockouts. And we've seen spinning back kick knockouts. The most notable one to me was David Loazzo. I don't even know who he was fighting, but that was the best spinning back kick in MMA I've ever seen. Of all times, Benny the Jet Urquidez has the best spinning back kick of all time. Okay, now, should you do a spinning back kick? Should you put them in your curriculum? Should you practice them? Should you train with them? And should you use them in the cage or the street? That's the question. So let's answer it right now. Okay. There's a huge difference between a spinning back fist, a spinning elbow, and a spinning back kick in MMA or the street and karate or kickboxing. So kickboxing and karate, they're the same. Spinning back kick. The benefits, the risks, and the rewards, they're the same. But now when you take it to MMA and the street, the rewards are the same. You might knock the guy out, you'll land a good technique, good points, etc. But the risk is much more dangerous. I have never seen a counter in karate or kickboxing off a spinning back kick. Like, I've never seen him punch anyone or anything. Like, if he's throwing a spinning back kick at me, I've never seen somebody try to counter it, okay? So I've never seen it. So you don't always score it because you're spinning and it takes longer, but I've never seen a risk involved. I've never seen a counter to it. So it's worth to throw all the time. There's no risk. There's tons of reward. Doesn't happen all the time, but there's still reward. In MMA, and especially the street, that's not the case because of takedowns. Not punching, but takedowns. Spinning techniques are more dangerous in MMA and the street because of takedowns, not because of counters. So you gotta be careful when you throw them, and you have to throw them differently. A spinning elbow and a spinning back kick is much different in karate and kickboxing than it is in MMA in the street because of the risk. Okay? You get more power in karate without the risk. You don't have that luxury in MMA. Let me show you what I mean. All right, now, if he's throwing a wide spinning back kick, he's getting a lot of power. Boom, that's the most powerful way to throw it. But if he's doing that in MMA or the street, watch. I can get his back. And then once you get his back, that means you can lift him up, you can suplex him, you can slam him, you can do all kinds of things. Okay, so the difference, let me show you. When I'm throwing that spinning back kick, I wanna wind up and throw it as hard as I can. But in MMA or the street, you don't have that luxury of going wide, because that's when they're gonna take your back. Watch, if I'm going wide, he can get your back, okay? So, you have to shorten it, which means it's not gonna be quite as powerful, but it's gonna be a lot safer to throw. And by shortening it, I mean almost try to think about bringing your knees together. Because you don't quite as get as much power as torquing it, but it's a lot safer. So if he's trying to take me down and I'm throwing it shorter, I'm still, even if I don't hurt him as much, I'm still creating that distance where he can't come in and get my back as easily, okay? So let me show you on the pad with the spinning back kick. You get more power when I open up my hip more and engage my hip into the spinning back end. I get more power, okay? But I've just left myself a lot more vulnerable, so I don't wanna do that. And I can still get enough power shortening it up, but I'm much less vulnerable, okay? So that is the difference. And that's what you should be training if you're in MMA or the street. If you're in karate or kickboxing, throw it wider and get more power. It's great. But you don't have that luxury in MMA or the street. All right? So with that said, let's talk about the next technique, the spinning elbow. Okay? I don't need anything. Okay, now with the spinning elbow, it's much more powerful to use the arc. So in other words, when you're spinning, you give it an arc, okay? The danger of that is if he ducks his head, boom, he's right there. I mean, when you throw your elbow, you have to be really close. So there's no margin for error, okay? So this one does get more power, but I'm giving up something. And that's what I mean by that is coming over like the arc of your shoulder, you spin it this way. So it comes up and then down. Kind of like an overhand hook or an overhand right, because that is the way our shoulder is, right? That's why people throw the ball that way. It's the arc, all right? It's a lot safer, not as powerful, but a lot safer in MMA or the street to come up. So when he comes at me, I'm here, okay? So I'll show you from this side. I'm coming up because the biggest counter somebody's gonna give you in the street or MMA is a takedown. They're trying to get your back. They're not trying to time it and punch you. They're trying to get your back. So the best way to prevent that, right, is to come up at an angle. Okay, so you're coming up this way instead of over, because if I'm coming over, he can duck under it easier, okay? So, with that said, that is the difference between sport karate, kickboxing, MMA in the street. They're very different in the way that they use, throw, the risks and rewards of spinning techniques. So you have to train them differently if you're a karate or kickboxer than you do if you're an MMA fighter or training for the street. Okay? They still can be used in both. You just have to train them differently, throw them differently, practice them, and learn them differently. All right? So throw your spinning techniques with all of the confidence you can. Just make sure you throw them right. All right? Go, have fun, spin and have fun.
Spin.
Spin. Thanks for coming.
Hey.